Welcome to DSL classes. In this video, we are giving you a complete introduction of the lab apparatus. As you know, when you move in the lab for the practical work, you handle different type of apparatus there. Then what purpose of these apparatus, how they are useful for your work, we are giving the introduction for that apparatus. First is the boiling tube, which is having 40 ml capacity, and if you want to boil less amount of liquid, then you can take the test tube. For different chemical reaction, we use this test tube. And the small tube, which this is a small tube, which is the ignition tube in which we ignite the solid compound. While boiling the liquid in the test tube, we must use a holder, which is called the test tube holder. And remember one thing very important, always wear the gloves while performing the practicals. Now if you want to hold anything, any ignition tube or any other thing, then this is a tong. The spatula can transfer the solid from one place to another. It is very helpful for transferring the solid. Similarly, when you hold the solid in any bowl-like structure, then it is the china dish. And when you keep the solid in the transparent glass, then it is watch glass. This is a dropper, which is very helpful in transferring the liquid from one place to another, from one beaker to another beaker. And this is a glass rod. Glass rod we can use for mixing any solid in the liquid or making any homogeneous solution of liquid in liquid or solid in liquid. This is helpful in mixing the substance. You can also say it stirrer. Now when you want to wash the test tube after the chemical reaction, then it is a brush. Now coming to the measuring part, there are so many type of cylinder, measuring cylinders having the capacity of 1 liter, 500, 200, even smaller like 50 ml, 10 ml. These all are called measuring cylinder, which may be made up of plastic or glass also. Then if you want to keep any liquid, then this is a beaker. Again, beaker are of different capacities, 1 liter, 500 ml, 200, 50 ml, having the mark on the their wall. Next is the apparatus for the volumetric analysis. This is a burette in which we fill unknown compound for the titration. And it is conical flask. After this, we are seeing the pipette. Pipette is used for the pipette outing the unknown solution in during the volumetric titrations. Sorry, we always fill the known solution in the burette and fill the solution with the help of funnel. This is funnel, and you can see the liquid like water. They are filling the water in the burette. Funnel is also made up of plastic or glass. Now coming to the weighing part. This is a weighing balance. Of course, in CBSC, the CBSC don't allow the weighing balance, digital weighing balance. It always permits the use of analytical balance. This is analytical balance, and these are the weights. This is a weighing box and weighing tube. In weighing box, we are having different type of weight boxes, starting from the 1 gram to 1000 gram. This is weighing tube, and this is analytical balance. But nowadays, we all labs are using the digital balance due to the shortage of the time. So thank you, Manish and Gagan. Now you can see the boiling apparatus. This is a net, tripod stand, and the spirit lamp. If you are doing the boiling up to the less amount of heat is required, then you can use the spirit lamp for the convenience, or for the high heating, you can use the Bunsen burner. And for noting the temperature of the solution, you can use thermometer. This is clinical thermometer and having the